We're at Schweitzer Natural Area along Johnson Creek in an area that's been recently rehabilitated upstream, but downstream we're looking at some of the old urban channel that shows both effects of agriculture and urbanization over time. I have with me Gardner and Janine here. And Gardner, you're familiar with the area. What's been some of the history on the watershed as far as the development over time?
Well, this Johnson Creek watershed upstream at this point is fairly highly developed, both in urbanization as well as agricultural impacts. A lot of the areas along the streams historically would have been cedar forest with a lot of interconnected wetlands that were connected to the channel that provided all sorts of complex fish habitat. Agriculture and urbanization have been the primary impacts here, as well as timber harvest very early on. And those impacts have resulted in lots of changes to the stream channel in this area. One of the most fundamental changes in this area was confinement of the channel into a straightened and hardened channel, and this was done in the 30s by the Works Progress Administration, WPA. And you can see that here, there's a grouted stone bank, trapezoidal channel, very straight, very simplified. The wood's been pulled out, the habitat has been severely degraded for aquatic species like salmon, which we had in large numbers historically, but in very few numbers relatively now. So there's been some large impacts.
So we have the changes in the watershed and then also some changes of immediate effects in the channel itself. Janine, what's changed about the sediment characteristics as well in this watershed?
Well, it's very common in urbanized watersheds to see a change in the sediment, the type of sediment in the stream. And in Johnson Creek in particular, we've seen a decrease in the coarse sediment, the gravels and the cobbles, the bigger material, which creates the habitat, physical habitat for the fish. And we've seen an increase in the fine sediments, so the silts and the clays, which ends up as more turbid, kind of muddy water coming through during storm events.
So we have we have a very mature, somewhat mature forest behind us. It looks very beautiful, but yet, you know, we have the stream channel that's been disconnected from its floodplain, as well as the changes within the channel itself with the habitat, as well as the watershed changes in hydrology and sediment. So a lot of things going on here.